Penguin Audio presents Omens by Kelley Armstrong. Read by Carine Montbertrand and Mozhan Marnò.
Prologue. Eden crawled into the living room, the rough carpet burning her chubby knees and hands. As boots slapped the hall floor, she went still, holding her breath. Had he heard her? The footsteps stopped. She leaned back around the doorway and peeked down the dark hall. There was no sign of him. Not yet. But he'd come for her. He always did. She crept a little farther, resisting the urge to leap to her feet and run. He'd hear her if she ran. Once she was past the big chair, she stopped and looked around. The long table in front of the sofa had a cupboard. She opened the door, wincing at the click. The space was big enough to squeeze into, but it was full of books and magazines. She glanced back at the big chair. It was too far from the wall. If she hid behind it, he'd see her as soon as he came around the corner. But the sofa? Yes. She flattened onto her stomach. Then she wriggled backward until her legs were all the way under and... Her bum hit the frame and stopped her. She tried again, squirming madly, but she couldn't get under. Maybe if she went in head first. She tugged herself forward and... She was stuck. She wiggled as hard as she could, the carpet burning her knees, but she couldn't get loose, and she was sure any moment now he'd... She popped out. She took a second to catch her breath. Then she turned around to go in head first and... Her head wouldn't fit under either. What about behind the sofa? If she could move it out a little, she could get in there. She grabbed the leg with both hands and pulled. It wobbled, but didn't move. The footsteps started again, slow and steady. Coming her way? She swallowed and tried to listen, but her heart was pounding so hard she could barely hear. She skittered from between the table and sofa and glanced at the hall leading to the bedrooms. Lots of hiding places back there. Better hiding places. If she could... Eden? She dove for the sofa and pushed it forward just enough so she could squish in behind. She tried to look back to make sure her feet were hidden, but she couldn't tell. She wiggled in a little farther, and then she pressed her hands to her mouth. If she made any noise, any at all, he'd find her. She lay on the carpet, trying not to sniff the old cat pee as she made herself as small as possible. Footsteps thudded into the room and stopped. When Eden squeezed her eyes shut, she could hear the slight rasp of his breathing. She pictured him there, brushing his shaggy blonde hair from his eyes as he scanned the empty room. Eden? He called. His boots swished on the carpet as he took a few more steps. He sucked in a breath. She's gone. Oh my God, Pammy, our baby's gone. Eden pressed her fist into her mouth to stifle a laugh. Mommy's soft sigh wafted from the kitchen as she told Daddy, again, not to use language like that in front of their daughter. But she's disappeared, he said. Call the police! Call the fire department! Call the clown brigade! Speaking of clowns, her mother teased. Eden's body shook with silent giggles. Our baby is gone. All that's left is this shoe. He dropped to his knees by the sofa. Wait, there's a foot in it. Eden twisted around, pulling her leg in. Oh no, now she's completely disap... Eden backed out of her hiding place and launched herself into Daddy's arms. He scooped her up and twirled her around. She closed her eyes as the air whipped past, smelling of Daddy's spicy aftershave. Much better than the cat pee from the old owners, but when she was spinning, the smell made her tummy spin too. She didn't tell him to stop, though. She'd never tell him to stop. Daddy tossed her onto the sofa. The bright red pillows scattered as she landed. He picked up one and tucked it under her. Then he bent on one knee. I'm sorry, sweetheart, but I have to leave. I've got a big day ahead of me, helping a special girl celebrate her half birthday.
Me!
Eden bounced on the cushion, singing,
me, me, me.
Really? Are you sure?
More shouting, more bouncing. Today, she turned 2.5. Last night, she'd barely slept, just curled up under the covers and stared at the mural Mommy had painted on the ceiling, a carousel of horses and swans and lions. Usually, if she couldn't sleep, She pictured herself on the black horse with the white mane, and she'd go around and around until she drifted off. That hadn't worked for a long time last night. Then, when Mommy came to wake her up, Eden heard an owl hooting outside her window, and her tummy had started to hurt. She didn't like the owl, not in the daytime. It sounded scary, and it made her worry that Mommy and Daddy would forget it was her half-birthday. But that had been silly. They'd never forget. "Is it time?" she said, still bouncing. "Is it time?"
"It is. We have a big surprise planned. Do you know what it is?"
"No, she does not," Mommy said as she walked in. "That's the concept of a surprise, Todd."
Daddy leaned down to Eden's ear and whispered, "Pony ride."
Eden shrieked. Her mother rolled her eyes and pretended to be mad, but she couldn't stop smiling. "Let's get your hair brushed," Mommy said as Eden jumped into her arms. "We'll want to take lots of pictures when you get your big surprise."
"Pony ride," Daddy said.
"I think we should put him on a pony," Mommy whispered in Eden's ear. When Mommy finished brushing her hair, Daddy grabbed Eden again and swung her up onto his shoulders.
"I think I'd make a good pony."
He snorted and pawed the ground. Mommy laughed and slapped him on the bum. Then the door crashed in. It happened so fast that nobody moved. Not Mommy, not Daddy. Eden heard the crunch of breaking wood, and she saw the door fly right off its hinges, and she thought it was a storm like in the movie with the girl and her dog. Only it wasn't a storm. It was monsters. Huge monsters, all in black, with helmets on their heads and masks over their faces. They swarmed through the broken door. They shouted and yelled and waved black things in their hands. Eden screamed then, and Daddy stumbled back, and Eden started to slip off his shoulders. Mommy caught her before she fell. One of the monsters shouted. Eden couldn't understand him. Mommy and Daddy did, though. They stopped moving. Then Daddy backed up, arms going wide, shielding Mommy and Eden. Two monsters grabbed him by the shoulders and threw him to the floor. Eden screamed again, screamed as loud as she could, her mouth open so wide that her eyes squished shut and she couldn't see. When Mommy's arms wrapped around her, she could feel Mommy's heart pounding, heard her panting, smelled something bad and sour that was not like Mommy's smell at all.
"It's okay," Mommy whispered. "Don't look, baby, just don't look."
Then Mommy shrieked, and everything spun. Eden's eyes flew open. One of the monsters had Mommy. Another yanked Eden away. Mommy grabbed for Eden, her nails raking Eden's arm as she tried to get her back. Eden fought just as hard to get to her, kicking and screaming and clawing. One of the monsters said Mommy and Daddy's names, then started saying other names, a whole bunch of them. Mommy stopped fighting then. So did Daddy, who was pinned to the floor under two monsters.
"What?"
Mommy said, her voice so squeaky it hurt Eden's ears.
"Those poor couples in the papers?"
She glanced at Daddy.
"What's going on?"
I don't know.
He looked at Eden. "It's okay, sweetheart. I know this is scary, but it's just a mistake. A bad, bad mistake." A woman appeared then, a normal woman, dressed in a jacket and a skirt, like the kind Grandma Jean wore to work. Only it didn't matter if she was smiling and talking in a nice voice, not when she took Eden away from Mommy and Daddy. Eden struggled and kicked and howled.
"Enough of that now," the woman said. "You're going to hurt yourself."
Eden bit her, chomped down on the lady's arm as hard as she could, tasting something bad and hot filling her mouth. The woman shrieked and let go, and Eden tumbled to the floor, then ran toward Mommy and Daddy as the monsters hauled them away. Mommy twisted around and reached out. Eden threw herself at her, but a monster grabbed her dress and held her back as another dragged Mommy out the door.
Chapter 1. I waited in the shelter drop-in center for my next appointment. The murmur of children's voices wafted in from the play area, low murmurs, hesitant, fractured. Guilty giggles cut short, as if the children weren't sure they had anything to giggle about. The faint smell of bleach from the toys.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.